Welcome to my channel. If this is the first time, please subscribe, like, and share. We'll be making these trendy shirt colors, and this is what it's going to be looking like, the block shirt color type, and this is what the rose shirt color type, and this is the shawl shirt color. And we'll be making all of this is, you are saying, I'll be teaching you how to draft this and how to make it look like this. This is half pattern for my shirt. This is half pattern, but I focused on the color because that's the main thing we're doing. So we'll be starting with this rose shirt color. This rose shirt color, we'll be starting with it, and the first thing I need to do is to know the depth of my neckline. The depth I'm going to be using here is 6.5 inches. 6.5, you can go down by 7 if you want. 6.5 inch is what I'm going to be going down. I don't want it too open, I don't want it too down, and I don't want it too up. So 6.5 inch is okay, and I'll be adding 1 extra inch all the way down. That is from the top to the down. That will be my button line. That will be where I'll be putting my button. So after that, what I'm going to be doing is to connect my shirt, that's my 6.5 inches, towards my neckline. But before then, I'll be adding extra 1/2 inch from that line towards the outer part and towards the inside. That is 1/2 inch. I'll be connecting this line from the 6 inches to the 1/2 inch that I have marked out, and after that, I will be going up by 3 inches. That is for my back pattern. My back pattern neckline is 3 inches, so I'll be going up by 3 inches, so that by the time I sew it in, it will be match. And what I'll be doing is to come down from that 3 inches to my neckline, and I'll be adding one inch up, one inch to the up, to the where the 3 inches stopped, and I will connect it to my shoulder. So this is kind of different somehow neckline, but look at the way it winds through, so that you can be able to do yours too. So from this place, I'll be coming out by 2 inches to get this rose that you are saying. To get it, I'll be coming out by 2 inches, and that 2 inches, I'll be marking the center, which is 1 inch. Remember that this is from your edge of your pattern. Then I'll be marking a dot. That dot I will come down by 1 inch and connect that 1 inch I came down by to that 1 inch center. That is, as you can see me, I'm using my pencil to trace it. And once I came down, I'm using my armhole curve to connect it to that 6.5 inch. As you can see, this is not what you use. This is what you have to use manually, use your hand and do. I'll be coming up by 1 inch again. This is to do for the other upper part, and I will be connecting this 1 inch to the inside 1 inch, and I'm trying to use my pen to do it so that it can be possible for you to see, and I'll be connecting it to the upper part. Then from here, I'll be going up by 3.5 inches. That's what I'll be going up by, because I want it to be bold. By the time you fold it, it will be 1.5 inside and 1.5 outside. So I'll be going up by 3 inches all the way to that extra what will I call it, in fact, to the rose line. To the rose line. So once I have connected it, and it's looking like what you're seeing on your screen. So what I'm going to do is to cut it out so that you can see what is looking like after I was done cutting it.
World can think like me. I'm twisted, how contradicted. Keep him addicted. Lies on his lips, I lick it. Unique? That's what you are. Stilettos kicking vintage crystal off the bar. Category, bad bitch, I'm the bar. Alien superstar. Whip, whip.
Too classy for this world. Forever I'm that girl. Beat you diamonds and pearl. Ooh, baby, I'm too classy to be touched. I paint them all in dust. I'm stingy with my love. Ooh, baby, you're.
So this is what it's looking like, and it came out nice. Very, very nice. It came out nice. Very, very nice. So And remember, if you want to cut this on fold. So now we'll be cutting the second one, which is the block. This is the block shed collar. So what I will be doing is to come down. I'll be coming down by 1 inch, and I'll be coming out by 2.5 inches, and that's 1 inch. I will draw a straight line. It's not like a straight line, like a fading line. Then after doing that, I will come out by 1 inch. 1 inch is still for the button allowance. That is the one, that's the reason for the 1 inch extra, 1 inch. And what I'll be doing is to go down by 6.5, and when I've gone down by 6.5, I'll be coming out from my neckline 1/2 inch inwards and 1/2 inch outwards. So I'll be connecting from the inward inch 1/2 inch to the 6.5 inch, 6.5 inch that I did for the down. And I'll be adding extra 3 inches to the shoulder for my back pattern. I'll be adding extra 1 inch all the way to the 3 inches, and I'll be connecting it together. I'll be connecting the lines, and what I'm going to do is mark my 3 inches or 3.5 or 4 inches. It depends on what you want to do. And now I'll be connecting from this, my 6 inches, to that 2 inches that I marked out from that line, 2.5 inches, sorry. So when you are doing this, mind you, your shape, the way you are shaping it out, so that it will come out like what you want it to look like. This, I think this is the easiest one to do among these three, the easiest ones. As you can see, is already ready. It's already ready. So let me cut it out and we can see what it looks like.
World can think like me. I'm twisted, how contradicted. Keep him addicted. Lies on his lips, I lick it. Unique? That's what you are. Stilettos kicking vintage crystal off the bar. Category, bad bitch, I'm the bar. Alien superstar, whip, whip.
I'm too classy for this world. Forever, I'm that girl. Beat you diamonds and pearls. Ooh, baby, I'm too classy to be touched. I paint them all in dust. I'm stingy with my...
So I'm done cutting it out, and this is what it's looking like, and it's exactly what I want it to be. It's exactly what I want it to be like, and this is what it's looking like here. So we'll be cutting out this type, this shawl type of collar. So what we're doing is to come down by 6.5 inches, as usual, like we did for the other ones, and we add an extra 1 inch all the way down. That is for the shirt, for the button, for button space for the shirt. And what I'm going to do is to also mark my 6 inches, connect the lines from my neckline all the way to where the 6 inches stopped. And remember, you have to come out by 1/2 inch on your neckline. You have to come out by 1/2 inch and extend your collar. I'll be extending my 3 inches like usual for the back pattern neckline. And after connecting, I'll be going all the way 1 inch down, one inch all the way down. And after connecting it, what I'm going to do, add the extra what I needed. That will be 3.5 inch. That's what I'll be needing for the size of the collar. And what I'm going to do is to come out from there 2.5 inch or 2 inches from there. It depends on what you want to do. Then I will now connect this one. Because of the shape, I'll use my armhole cuff and connect it from there to that 2 inches, 2.5 inches, sorry, to that 2.5 inches. And as you can see, it's looking like what the picture you are seeing on your screen. And I will be cutting it out, and we're going to see how it turned out. And I know it turned out good.
World can think like me. I'm twisted, how contradicted. Keep him addicted. Lies on his lips, I lick it. Unique? That's what you are.
So this is what it looked like when I was done cutting it and folding it, like the way it's supposed to be when I'm done stitching it together on my fabric. and this is looking nice. Like, this is looking nice. Thank you for watching. This is what all of them, the three of them, is looking like, and this is what they are looking like. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you. Please, if this is your first time, subscribe. See you next time. Thank you.